Okay, today's project is a backgammon table that I made probably 20 years ago. I had a lady approach me about making a backgammon table that flips down flat against the stand, or you can flip it up to play your game. She had a pattern for me to go by, another table. So I made it to same dimensions as that table, and I made it out of cherry. And she came and got the original and the one I made. A couple months later, asked if I would make another one. So she had to bring the original back again, because I didn't mark anything down. And when I made it this time, I thought, if there's a chance she wants another one, I'll make two while I'm at it. So that was about 20 years ago. And this one's been sitting in my garage. That's why the cherry looks like it's aged pretty good. But you'll see what when I get it back together. There's two drawers for the game pieces. This is the frame for the top. The insert, you can see, fits in that rabbited out area. And that's out because there's pieces being made of felt to lay out the playing area. So that's in the house where it's a little warmer today, kind of nasty outside. So we'll go in and I'll show you what that looks like in progress, and then the next one will be when it's all done, hopefully. And here's the game pieces being made. We have brown and cream, and dark green for the background. And they'll go on this piece of birch plywood that I laid out. And when it's all done, we'll put everything back together, show you the finished product.
Same size, right?
Yep. Okay, we're back with the backgammon table. All the felt pieces have been glued down. Came out pretty nice. Now this gets put into this frame. And I marked it before I took it out. So, the same orientation. First look at it here. So we'll go ahead and get it all together. I just have some screws in the back. These hinges are on here to mount onto our stand. I'll come back when I'm ready to put it on there. Next few minutes, just going to be putting screws in the back here, screwing it back to the frame. So we'll pause this and come back. There's the frame on. I'll bring it a little closer. It's pretty smart with that Pennsylvania cherry on there. So now we'll get it mounted on a stand. A little pivot out point. To hold it when it's flat, comes up, hold it flat. Keep in mind, I had this together once and it's been sitting around for about 20 years, so let's see if we can get it back on there. Get set up here with some screws. bought this many years ago. Little DeWalt, I don't know, 4-point-some volts. And it works by it senses which way you want to twist once you pull the trigger. So you just get it started. Give a little twist and it takes right off. Good for delicate little hinges like this. Made these little drawers for the game pieces. They're not here yet, but they will, one for each player, of course. Goes in there. Pretty simple. Don't know why I made them that way, but I did. Anyway, goes in there. And I put them on that side so that not playing, I'm going to put it against the wall, hold it down. There. You're on a flat surface, pretty stable. Ready to play a game, you can flip it up, and if you want, underneath here, a little tiny wedge there. And you just pop this out, bring this over, makes it nice and snug. There you go. In case somebody leans on it, it won't flip over. It has a little stability. So the game pieces should be here tomorrow, I'm hoping, and with the dice. So, when I get them, we'll have a game. Enjoy. Thanks for watching.